And we live. Alright, we hear the music in the back. Now I'm here eating. Starving, but whatever it's called. We're gonna talk about unconditional love. I'm out of here. You know? I'm out of here. Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, but, let me stop playing. We're gonna talk about unconditional love. Because I feel like with love, there are many different types of love. One is unconditional. Now, for me, I can say unconditional love is when you have a kid. It's the best way to describe it. When you have a kid, you want to do anything. Sorry, I just got cut off. Somebody tried to call me. Any and everything for that kid, right? So it's like unconditional love. No matter what they do, they can do the dumbest thing. And you're like, stop. Why are you doing that? You're still going to come back and help your kid no matter how dumb or no matter what they do, right? That's unconditional love. Now, can that kind of love be transitioned from just a child or somebody of you but somebody that you love? But how do you know that you have that unconditional love if, and this is what I'm saying, the reason why I feel like it's a big if is because there's a lot of divorces going on. And when you pledge these things, you go into it, you're supposed to know about all of this unconditional love, because all the other love doesn't matter. You understand? Like, you know, it's a sex matters, but you still have to have a conversation. You still have to have that energy. You have to, you know, like going out with them, joking around. You know, you kind of miss the beginning. It's like, some people have all this stuff to do. Like, they live here, they gotta work here, they got these kids. But you gotta learn to manage your time, I think. Because love is about managing and communication and understanding a person. Because sometimes you gotta sacrifice your time a little bit more because you want to be happy with this person that you want to give this unconditional love to, right? That's just mine. You know, if you want to talk about it more, you can comment about it, or you can go live and we go live. Because I go live. Hey, I go live. My bad, the Spanish way. I'm eating little bread. Okay, so right now we're just relaxing. I know it's Monday, but sometimes it's better to take a day off than push yourself and hurt yourself, you know? I got stitches. Don't forget, I got like 5 stitches over there. I got to take them out today. But anyways, we'll be back. I see I got like 2 viewers. Ooh, I went from 2. Boy, I had 1 last time to 2. We stepping up. We are going somewhere. Y'all better stop playing. You better tell people to watch me, because I was at 1 yesterday. Today's 2. Tomorrow it might be 3. It might go back down to 1, but it doesn't matter. It might not even be any, but it doesn't matter. Somebody's going to watch me. And I just like to talk and have fun. And keep it real, all right? No games, like I always say, over and out. Don't stop, I'll be back. Oh, I got 3 views? Should I talk about some more now? I got 3 views. Woo! Nah, we not going nowhere now. Now you're going to sit here and eat with me. I got 5. I'm going up, I got 5. My heart is behind. Oh, I got 5 y'all went down. Why you left? I was at 5. I was at 3. This is heartbreaking. Why y'all playing with my emotions? But it's okay. But anyways, let's talk about. What I was talking about was something that's really close to my heart, right? And I was talking about perception. The perception that you kind of give off to people. And don't you think that's a good conversation to talk about? Perception, right? Because everybody perceives a person to be so good on the outside. Like, it's something like how, forgive me for not remembering the guy's name that passed away recently. Kimbo Slice, matter of fact. You use him. He passed away so early in his 40s. It's like, your outside looks good, but your inside is not really healthy. People need to start really eating better. And I know it's hard. I don't think he was sick, but I'm just saying, I don't know. I know he had a heart attack. And sometimes heart attack can come from anything. You know, it could be from family. And, you know, I send my condolences out to that because that's nothing to, like, just throw out there like that. But, you know, I feel like sometimes people are trying to help people so much because you look at some of the things he said. He wanted to do so much for his kids. And that's good. You always want to do as much as you can for your kids. But you got to take care of yourself, too, so for your kids so you can be there and not, you know. And that's kind of where I got in my stage of life now. It's like I would just eat just anything. And didn't really care, and like, oh, you know, I'll be alright. But you know, it catches up to you sometimes. And I think, you know, we gotta notice sometimes that, like, rather than just paying like a couple dollars to grab something real quick, that's not good for you. Why don't you take a couple more dollars, add on like 3-4 to eat something that's healthy that can stay in your body a little longer and make you feel a little bit better for that throughout the day? Because you know, you gotta deal with some people, and it's not easy dealing with some different people, you would say. Because we don't want to be, you know, we want to use better words than just always cursing. But different people, that you got to have the patience to break down some things to some people. Some people really are not as smart as others. They don't have that common sense. So you got to discuss that too in a relationship. What's your common sense? And what is her common sense? Because that is where problems come in. And sometimes you got to lose the battle to win the war. But anyways, I don't really know what I'm talking about, right? But I still got 4 viewers. It's going back and forth from 4 and 5, so you know I'm doing better. Like I told you, it's all about pushing for your dream. I want to be, so I'm going to tell you this. This is my dream, and I don't really tell everybody, but I want to tell everybody because I like this dream. I want to be a motivational speaker. So maybe I can, maybe I can't. I got 5 viewers. That doesn't mean I'm going to try. I'm not going to try, right? But I'm still going to do it. But I want to be a motivational speaker, and if you really, really want to get to know why I want to be a motivational speaker, I'm going to talk a little bit more about it. You know what I mean? Get down and dirty. Now I don't remember. Come on, Randy. Don't play with me, my boy. It's like that. Nah, we in here, though. I see you, Randy. We got a couple of my. We got JT, Shelly, Randy. I don't know how to say this one, but she joined it. I don't even know what the first part is, but we in here. We in here. We live. But, I'll be back in a little bit. I got to finish. I want to eat. I might read a book a little bit, try to help myself out. I'm reading this book. Let me see my book. Let me show this book that I'm reading. This is the beginning. It's right here. It's a very good book. Very good book. It opens your mind. Some people are very closed-minded. You have to open up your mind nowadays because there's so much going on. Like, it's so much. You know, it's a lot, though. It's a lot of changes. Like, how are you going to deal with the changes with these different relationships? But even though it's personal, right? Like, those relationships are, like, personal. Like, if you're gay or lesbian or whatever, transgender or, you know, whatever that your gender is, it's like it's hard to deal with, and it's a change, and it's like sometimes if you just have somebody to like listen to you, it helps.
Like you.
I'm not saying I want to listen to everybody. I listen to some people, but I'm just saying it's good to like to feel comfortable because you don't want to go anywhere and feel like they're treating you different because of your personal life, not because of how smart you are, not because of how you are very just good at something, you know, like basketball player, football player, or a doctor, or somebody that works into like, medical billing or something. Maybe that, I don't know. Or in marketing, you know, it's a lot of things. You want to be good at what you do. You know what I mean? So it's not easy to be good at what you do, but you got to push. And you're going to get pushed back. It's like if somebody punches you, you're just going to stay down, or you're going to get up. You got to get up sooner or later. I took a bread break, and you know we out here, so we with the boss. We bossed up. Yeah, no, I'm joking. Good. Sometimes you just gotta play around. That's the good thing about life. You can be any kind of character you wanna be, right? Oh God, I'm gonna really have to take some of these boss break. I have to take a boss break. Don't laugh. Boss in it. This is some dry, bro. It's good. It's good though, but it's dry. It's good. But yeah, I like to talk though in general, and I'm starting to do this because I feel like people like to talk and talk about things, but they kind of hold it in. And I'm the type of person that talk about anything. So what I want to start doing too is if you know anybody that wants to get interviewed by me, because I'm doing it raw, like I just ask about anything. See my stitches? Yeah, they right there, man. See them?
Hey, come on, buddy.
All right, but I'm seriously. I want to start interviewing people. So if you think you want to be interviewed or I got it, or you want, just inbox me with serious stuff. Because I'm going to ask you some serious questions about everything that I know about you or that you think I don't know or that I do know that you may not know that I know, you know? So if you know that I want to know, let me know in my inbox and then we'll know. But right now, I'm about to bust down this food. And like I said, go read my book a little later for a little bit and I'll get back to you. Hey, like I always said, over and out. Check me.